thank you so much for your time and welcome on Rising Stars. All right, before I actually start with the questions, since it's all set house, you've been living in Delhi.
Yes, of course. I was Joint Secretary in the Ministry of Rural Development. I'm 1994 batch IAS officer and I sought voluntary retirement from service. And this was the quarter allotted to me, government accommodation.
Okay.
And my hobby is interior decoration.
Oh, your hobby is interior decoration.
So that's how
it is. That's why it's so pretty and nicely done up.
Yes.
Okay. So you've been here with on deputation with the government of
India. I was. In fact, from August 2013 to August 2018, I was in deputation to government of India.
All right.
And I was joint secretary here working for the government.
Yeah, and in fact, that is what I want to ask you, Mr. Prajita. 2018 September, I was reading your bio, and 2018 September is when you quit as a bureaucrat. So you were in service as recent as last year. It's not even 1 year till now. So when was this decision taken?
Yes, that's all like a fairy tale to me even. Even sometimes I feel, I mean, how did it happen? In the last 7 months, my life has taken a U-turn, I would say. In fact, I was the Joint Secretary here, and let me honestly tell you, in the last 25 years of my service in the IAS, at the best of postings, in state government also and Government of India also.
Okay.
In Government of India, I was given the charge of MNREGA, MGNREGS, and which is the largest anti-poverty program of the world. One fine evening, I was sitting with my family, and I just, you know, talked to them. My husband is also my batchmate.
Yeah.
He's also 94 batch. He was Joint Secretary of Commerce till recently.
Okay.
So we were all sitting together, and I just, you know, I just told them that I was planning to go for a larger canvas.
Okay.
And I wanted to render public service on a larger scale from a larger platform. And when I was a government servant, I never thought of entering into politics. There was absolutely no question. So satisfied I was.
So you're saying this happened all of a sudden last year?
Almost. Almost. Okay. Couple of weeks, I would say. It was not so sudden. But that evening, I think, was the evening when we decided that I would quit. And I have three pillars of strength in my life, my husband and my two children. So three of them approbated my stand. And they said, you must go if you want to. And politics to me is a great way of rendering public service. And that's how I thought I would go to politics.
And then what happened next? Because you got a ticket from the BJP. It's so difficult to get a ticket from the Bharatiya Janata Party. For the last 5 years, I've known so many people who wanted a ticket. How did this happen?
Two reasons. One, of course, its leader was Prime Minister Modi.
Okay.
And number two, the reason was I wanted a party which was development oriented, development focused, since I was from the civil services background. And orientation of BJP matches with my mental orientation, my mental makeup. And there was a leader whom I wanted to follow. So BJP was the only choice.
So you and approached or they approached?
It's a mutual love affair. Let's not get into that. But I'm sure I can say with conviction and
because there's a story going around.
Yeah,
there's a story going around that you were pretty much handpicked by Dharmendra Pradhan. So I am asking you, is that correct? Because he's a, you know, he's a minister from Orissa.
See, it's a mutual love affair. I mean, I like BJP, BJP liked me. So let's not get into the issues and how I got into it. But the best part is that I got into it and Prime Minister was kind enough to give me the ticket from Bhubaneswar. I'm really very much indebted to him. He had the trust, he had the confidence in me. And Bhubaneswar is the capital city of Orissa, the gateway to the state. And let me honestly tell you, BJP never won in Bhubaneswar. There was a BJD MP for the past 20 years in Bhubaneswar.
So how did you manage that? I want to ask, because you as a bureaucrat, you come from a family of a bureaucrat.
Yeah.
From where did you get the wherewithal to fight the elections? The party must have helped, I understand. But still, for somebody like you and quickly getting into electoral politics, it's not that you've spent
absolutely
time in
right.
the party.
Absolutely right. 27th November. The president of the party, respected Sri Amit Shah ji, actually inducted me into the party here.
And that is residence.
At his residence.
Yeah.
At his residence, in presence of all the major leaders of Odisha. And thereafter, 29th November, I remember, I was taken to the BJP party office in Odisha, and I was given a very rousy welcome by the BJP workers there.
Okay.
And let me honestly tell you, from 1st December, I was on the ground. Because more or less, you know, I had the feeling that I would be contesting from Bhubaneswar. So that idea had come to me. And then I wanted, and I knew that I was very new to the job.
Okay.
I had to get myself accepted by the BJP party workers on the ground. There was Prime Minister's wave in Odisha. On 16th of April, I remember he went there to canvass for me, his candidate. And that was the turning point. I'm really indebted to him, Honorable Prime Minister, for having found time to canvass for me.
Ma'am, you know, you as a IS officer, I want to ask you, what are you going to bring to the table? What are you going to bring to the politics of this country with the background of an officer from the Indian Administrative Service?
No, very good question. See, again, with humility, I would say that being in the IS for 25 years has definitely given me immense capability to comprehend a problem in a much better manner. Okay. What are the pros and cons? What kind of policy should be put into place? And how that policy needs to be implemented? How to get things done? See, ultimately,
execution.
Everything boils down to how you get things done.
Absolutely.
How can you be a go-getter?
Absolutely.
How can the last person in the chain get the benefit of what the government intends them to benefit from? So, you know, this is something which comes to me automatically being in the Indian Administrative Service, bring definitely some level of maturity, and I know how to get things done.
You know how to get things done, all right. Tell me one thing. You think the focus on people like you, ma'am, is more because you are somebody who brings in more than 20 years of administrative experience with you. Do you think the party that this is and the party that you are a part of will be perhaps looking more closely at candidates like you or member of parliaments like you for delivery and also perhaps for better performance?
I think they should. Why won't they? I think they should. They should raise the bar for people like us. And I would love to say that, you know, I would put in my best to rise up to their expectations.
Have you met the Prime Minister?
We have been meeting, you know.
No, did you get a one-on-one, that 2 minutes that he's giving to every candidate you've got?
Yes, of course. We have been meeting.
Okay.
We have been meeting. In fact, the other day also he had called the women MPs. It's a wonderful thing that he has started, you know, in groups he is meeting.
Yeah.
And he's talking to everybody, trying to know about the family, about everything. It's so very sweet. So we are very comfortable with Honorable Prime Minister.
What was his message to you in particular? Any message?
No, for everybody it was. I am also one of those. In fact, I should not be singled out. It's just that, you know, I assured him in that meeting that main aapko kabhi nirash nahi karungi.
Aapne bola ye unko?
Maine unko ye kaha.
Kya jawab tha unka?
He smiled. Maine kaha ki main unko kabhi nirash nahi karungi aur maine unko ye bhi kaha ki jitna main prashasanik seva mein kaam karti thi, मैंने कभी भी 13 या 14 घंटा से कम किसी दिन काम नहीं किया तो उससे ज्यादा काम मैं राजनीति में करूंगी. That's what I assured him.
That's what they're looking for, actually.
Too much of talk. I think let's go and have a cup of coffee.
You will step out, but before I go on, ma'am, I'm really curious here because I see a lot of Lord Ganesha idols,
yes,
lot of Lord Krishna idols.
That's right.
And actually Buddha idols here. Really nice.
You know, my husband and I, both of us are very much into interior decoration, and wherever he has gone or I go,
you've picked it up from different postings, is it?
Yes, different postings, different countries and different cities of the country.
Yeah.
So it's a passion. I mean, you know, one should live well. The surroundings should be good enough so that one performs better.
The good vibes.
The good vibes,
very,
the
very
positive
important
vibes.
Yeah. So I was reading a few articles on you. You being referred to as Madam Angry back home. I am wondering why.
See, I mean, that was quite a confusion. When you are in a chair.
Are you Madam Angry?
I am not at all.
As a not bureaucrat, are you that?
Sometimes you have to actually tell your people to fall in line if things are not done.
Okay.
As per.
Yeah.
And if it is a time bound, yeah, it's a time bound thing and the work is not done.
Huh.
Then you definitely kind of tell, point out that this should not be done and people should fall in line.
Yeah.
So that's not, I don't think that means that I'm Madam Angry. I'm anything but angry. Anger doesn't touch
angry
me. Yeah.
Final question to you. I have known Mr. Arup Patnaik for a very long time. He was Commissioner Mumbai and I was, you know, reporting out of Mumbai. So when this battle between you and Arup Patnaik, I think this was perhaps the most unique fight that we saw this election. a former IPS officer taking on a former IS officer in the town of Bhubaneswar. What worked in your favor? You defeated a Biju Janata Dal candidate that Mr. Arup Patnaik was, and a Odia himself. You are not a Odia. And you know, he would have gotten along with the locals much better than you did, but still you won hands down. And you know, somebody whose party has been there for 20 years, he couldn't make it against you.
See, I am Odia Bahu.
You're Bahu, and, but he's an Odia.
But and I would definitely tell you that I consider myself more of an Odia than any Odia.
Okay.
I love the culture.
So
I love the tradition.
Less of a Bihari, more of a Odia.
Absolutely.
Is that correct?
Yes,
the correct
absolutely.
Way to describe you? Okay.
Absolutely. And the very fact that people voted for me explains the fact that, you know, they know that I am an Odia. And I have a wonderful connect with people. I don't know, this chemistry is something which I'm very proud of. Okay. I'm blessed.
The chemistry and, worked in your favor.
The chemistry worked in my favor.
Wow, it worked wonderfully for you. Madam, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so
much. You've given us
thank
and wishing you.
You
all the very best. Thank you so much.
Thank you.